Morning friends, in the previous lecture we have determined the dimensions d is equal to 28 mm, t is equal to 11 mm, d3 is equal to 52 mm, a is equal to 10 mm, d1 is equal to 6 mm, d2 is equal to 44 mm and d4 is equal to 86 mm. Now in this session we will determine how to calculate the value of d1, that is this dimension. This is the dimension d1. Now for determining the dimension d1, we will consider the failure of socket in tension. This figure shows the failure of socket in tension. So figure will be like this. This is sectional view will be the resisting area. This is the final resisting area. Now we will study how to calculate this resisting area. Now this diameter is D2. Now just see, this outer diameter is D1. This diameter is D1. This is D1. And inner diameter is D2. Inner diameter is D2. Correct? So subtracting this from this, we will get this resisting area. That is, this area is equal to pi by 4 D1 square, because D1 is the diameter, and this area is pi by 4 d2 square, because this is diameter d2. Subtracting this from this, we will get pi by 4 d1 square minus d2 square. Now we have to subtract this to obtain this dimension. So this dimension is d2 and outer diameter is d1. So d1 minus d2 into t. T is the thickness. This area will be d1 minus d2 into t. So subtracting this from this, we will get this area, that is pi by 4 in the bracket d1 square minus d2 square minus in the bracket d1 minus d2 in the bracket multiplied by t. This is the total resisting area. In this way we have studied how to calculate the resisting area. Now as this failure is in tension, we will take permissible stresses in tension. This is the value of resisting area and this is the value of load. Putting the respective values of d1, that is to be calculated, values of d2, t and w, we will determine the value of d1. First we will form the quadratic equation. By following the quadratic equation and by solving this equation, we will get the value of d1, that comes out to be 52.78, and we will take the increased dimension. D1 is equal to 54 mm. In this way we have calculated the value of d1 by considering failure in tension of the socket. Now this is the end of the session. In the next session we will calculate the remaining dimensions of the quarter. Thank you very much.